This video is about vectors and scalars. Vectors and scalars. Most of the physical quantities that we deal with in engineering are either vectors or scalars, although there are some physical quantities that are neither vectors nor scalars, things like tensors, which you would learn about a little bit later. But the first question is, why do we need to create this differentiation between vectors and scalars? Now, most of the engineering is actually a mathematical science, which means that we have mathematical representation for the physical quantities. Now, let me give you a simple example. Let's say we have a person standing at point A, and this person moves to another location, point B, by a distance of 50 meters. Okay, so in this case, we would say the distance traveled by the person is 50 meters in going from point A to point B. Now, if I take the same person and have him move from point A to point B to point C, while the distance between A to B is 50 meters and between B to C is also 50 meters, and I ask you now what is the distance traveled, you would have no trouble saying that the person has moved by a distance of 100 meters going from A to B to C. Okay? If I have this person go from point A to point B and then have him come back, then also you would say distance traveled is 100 meters. So he went from A to B and came back to point A. Okay, but clearly there is some difference between this scenario one and scenario number two. Even though the distance traveled between the two points going from A to C and going from point A to B to A is same, you can clearly see that the person is displaced by different amount. In the scenario one, the displacement, which tells you something about the difference between the final position and the initial position of the person, is actually 100 meters, which is same as the distance traveled. But here, the displacement is zero, which clearly tells you that you cannot equate distance with the displacement. So in your day-to-day language, in your day-to-day conversation, you might say distance and displacement and use them synonymously. But in reality, the two things are actually different. So in engineering, we define these two terms differently. In fact, it turns out that distance is a scalar quantity, but the displacement is not. Now, the scalar quantity are defined only by a number, so just a single number, which we call magnitude also, magnitude. Some examples, mass. So mass of a person is 50 kilogram. You just need one number 50 to indicate it. Kilogram is a unit. Area. Area of a circle is 2 meters squared. Volume. Volume of a cube is 5 meter cube. Distance, which we just saw. Distance traveled by a person or a car is 1 kilometer. These are all examples of scalar quantities. And there are many more. Density. Work done by a force. Energy in a system. These are all scalar quantities because they require only one number to indicate as to what they are. Vector quantities, on the other hand, require a number as well as a direction. Example, displacement. So now, if you want to talk about a vector quantity, you have to talk about its magnitude, what its number is, as well as what the direction of that quantity is. Velocity. So if you want to talk about velocity, you have to say a person or a car is moving in a certain direction at a certain speed. So you might say, well, there is a person or a car moving at 5 miles per hour in the northeast direction. Okay. Or you might say this is 5 miles per hour, 45 degree from horizontal. Okay. Or 45 degree from east. Acceleration. Forces. Moments of a force, momentum. These are all vector quantities that require specification of both a number as well as a direction. Now, this definition that the vectors are defined by number induction is actually incomplete. This is only a necessary condition. So this is a necessary condition, but not sufficient, not sufficient. So what do I mean by that? What I mean is that there are certain quantities that seemingly possess both magnitude as well as direction, but are not necessarily vector quantity. So a very simple example would be a road sign. So let's say there is a road sign for a right turn at 30 miles per hour, and there is another road sign for a left turn also at 30 miles per hour. Okay. Vector quantities are required to have number and direction, but they should also satisfy one of the axioms of vector spaces, which says that if you take two vector quantities A and B and you add them together, the final result should not matter, should not be different if I change the order of operation. So if I do A plus B or I do B plus A, the final result should still be something less as C. Okay. Now for the vectors, this has to be true. This is one of the axioms of vector spaces. So when you take a class in linear algebra or vector algebra, you will learn 8 different axioms of vector spaces. This is one of them. This is called law of commutativity. So let's apply this law of commutativity on the road signs and see if this would be valid. And you right away see that's actually not going to be true, because if I take a right turn first, okay, let's say I start here. This is my starting point. And I take a right turn at 30 miles per hour, and then I take a left turn at 30 miles per hour, where would I go? So I take a left turn, I get here, right? So this is my destination. So this is basically doing A plus B. So assuming this is A, this is B, then I did A plus B. Now let's go back to the starting point and do B plus A. So B is the left turn. So I'm going to take a left turn. Let me choose a different color. I'll take a left turn, and then I'll take a right turn. And now my destination is here. Okay, so this is basically being done B plus A. Clearly the final result is not same, because our destination is not same. And that tells you that road signs are not vector quantity. Take electric current, for example. If you take electric current, you add them together, they don't behave like vectors. You take finite rotations, they also don't behave like vectors, even though they seem to have a direction as well as a magnitude.